and hey guys, today we'll be talking about some basic physiologies of the respiratory system.
So basically now we're about to cover up some easy and simple points about how the respiratory system works. In the area of the thoracic cavity, divided by the mediastinum, we have the right lung and left lung. And as the breathing cycle occurs, air is flowed down into the trachea and is divided into the bronchus, left and right, which divides at the level of the fifth thoracic vertebra. The bronchus then divides into branches of bronchioles and flows to the alveolar sacs. We will go deeper about the details of this process, but first, we should know some basic types of breathing rates. So first, we have eupnea, which is a good and normal breathing, also known as quiet breathing, or breathing during sleep. Then, we have some examples of increased breathing rate. For example, hyperpnea, which is increased depth of breathing due to a specific demand, such as during exercise. Then we have tachypnea, which is rapid breathing at a rate of 20 breaths per minute higher than normal rates. There are also some examples of a decrease in breathing rates. For example, hypopnea, which is episodes of overly shallow breathings that decreases its respiratory rate. We have bradypnea, which is a slow breathing rate that is usually affected by age. Plantipnea, which is a type of shortness of breath that is relieved by lying down and worsens when standing up. Orthopnea, which is the opposite of plantipnea, where shortness of breath occurs when lying down and relieves when standing up. We have dyspnea, which is a shortness of breath, also known as ear hunger, that exerts in heavy exertion and mainly pathological. And last but not least, we have apnea, which is a total absence of breathing. So enough of that, now let's go deeper and cover up some more basics about the lungs. Here is the horizontal fissure, which divides the upper and middle lobes. And this is the oblique fissure, which divides the middle and lower lobes. However, the left lung only has the oblique fissure, which divides between the upper and the lower only. So when inhalation occurs, external air from the environment enters the system. This causes the contraction of muscles that is attached to the ribcage, and the diaphragm contracts. While exhalation is exactly the opposite of it. And did you know that there will always be an amount of 1 liter of air in your lungs no matter how hard you try to exhale? Breathing rates are never the same. However, we can conclude that infants have an average of 30 to 60 breaths per minute, whereas adults have around 12 to 20 breaths per minute. And the average total lung capacity of adults is about 6 liters of air. But we only use a fraction of this daily. Let's take, for example, these four friends. First, we have this skinny guy. This guy is expected to have a higher lung volume compared to, let's say, this obese guy. Or we can see, for instance, this short guy. He is expected to have a lower volume compared to, let's say, this tall guy. While taking environmental factors into account, let's say this dude right here lives in a place with a higher altitude. This guy is expected to have a higher lung volume compared to, let's say, this guy who lives down here. And let's take into account a guy who regularly exercises. He is obviously going to have a larger lung capacity compared to this blue dude over here. Despite taking all of that into account, an adult can actually breathe around 11,000 liters of air every day. Got any questions? We are ready to answer any of your questions from the comments below. Stay tuned for more videos, and don't forget to subscribe and visit our page.